Minolta 35mm. Minolta was founded in Osaka, Japan in 1928. They weren't called Minolta at first. They were called Nichi Doku Shishinkai Shoten, which translates into Japanese German Photo Company. So Minolta is best known for making the world's first autofocus 35mm SLR. I bought my first Minolta in 1982. Now I take that back, 1983. And you're looking at it right now. I've taken a lot of pictures with this camera. Minolta made its first camera in 1929, and they named it the Nifkaret. In 1937, Minolta came out with their first twin reflex camera called the Minolta Flex. Twin reflex cameras, for those that don't know, look like this. In 1947, Minolta marketed their first 35mm rangefinder type camera called call the Minolta 35. In 1958, Minolta introduced their first 35mm SLR camera called the Minolta SR2. In 1962, astronaut John Glenn used a Minolta high-matic camera as he orbited the Earth in space capsule Freedom 7. I've always thought Minolta made some really nice cameras, very high quality, and I actually used this camera in a professional capacity for a while. And of course, if you use a camera professionally, you better have a backup. And here's my backup. A lot of people don't know it, but in 1972, Minolta signed an agreement with Leica in the development of SLR cameras. And in 1976, the Leica R3 is introduced. Minolta produced it, as well as the Leica R4 and Leica R5. In 1981, Minolta introduced the first camera with TTL metering, which means through the lens. Actually came out in a rangefinder camera called the Minolta CLE and in a 35mm SLR called the X700. X700 was so popular that they produced it for 18 years. Also has through the lens metering. In 1985, Minolta introduced the world's first autofocus SLR camera. They called it the Maxim system. Included the Maxim 7000, the 5000, and the 9000. This is a 5000. And it still works. And I shoot with it on a regular basis. I shoot black and white only. I've got a variety of flashes that I use on my cameras. One of my favorites, though, is a Sunpak 433D. Let's see if we can hear it. In the world of digital cameras, it's nice to be able to fall back on the analog.